with. Whether you like it or not, the people we interact with on a daily basis impact our lives in profound ways. Oftentimes, the shortest conversation can change the course of someone's day and offer a bright ray of happiness in an otherwise bleak and dreary one. So then why do we choose to ignore these opportunities? We tend to push people away when we need them the most. We think that they don't care, that they don't want to be bothered, which is usually the furthest thing from the truth. Psalm 121 states, "I lift my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore." How amazing would it be to have a community or small group of people that would protect us and keep us safe? The psalm states that God would be our protector, but I believe that we can protect each other. Every single person you let into your life can be your protector if you choose to let them. We have the potential to forge such incredible bonds with each other. Anxiety, insecurity, and uncertainty halt this process in its tracks. In the days of old, God may have been the protector, but I believe that God has given us the potential to fill this role. One of my favorite singers once said that insecurity kills all that is beautiful. The relationships between two or more people have the potential to become one of the most beautiful aspects. We have the ability to help each other, heal each other, and sometimes even save each other. Do you realize how much power that is? And it's not coming from a divine force. That power comes directly from us. We have the power to change and to be changed. All you have to do is take that first step. Psalm 121 also states that God will not let your foot slip, which I translated as God will not let you fall. Sometimes we need to fall, and in Batman Begins, Alfred summarizes this perfectly. He asks Bruce Wayne, "Why do we fall?" And answers, "So we can learn to pick ourselves up." It's easy to succumb to the fall. Some even become accustomed to it. And deep down, others may even want to feel miserable and weak. We victimize ourselves. Now, that doesn't mean the struggles and challenges we face are any less real or important, but what it does mean is that we can't let these issues consume us. I've always struggled with letting people in, and I still do. I've lived in three different states, and as a result, I never really got to know anyone well enough to even give them a chance. I became so used to this pack-up-and-go lifestyle that I became accustomed to cutting ties with one place and moving on to thankfully, I've always had my immediate family to depend on, but I've never really been able to enjoy my cousins and grandparents to the extent that I would like. As I look out at all the grandparents here today, just as I do every year, I'm struck with a sense of awe. For those of you who have grandparents, either here today or living nearby, take a moment to show them you love them. I've never been close with my grandparents, and I always wish that wasn't the case. If you're looking to take that first step and let someone in, your grandparents would be a great place to start. They won't judge you, and their love doesn't come at a price. I want to thank all the grandparents here today, because just by being here, you show them you either have or are willing to take on the role of the protector and friend. So I'm offering a challenge. Open up, talk to each other. Do away with small talk and actually discuss. Don't skate around your feelings, confront them. Hopefully by doing this, you'll be able to conquer anything that stands before you. Anxiety, insecurity, and doubt. These are what stand in the way of finding our protectors. This terrible trio will try to cripple you and prevent you from taking that first step and opening up. You'll question yourself, but you'll also question the intentions of others. What is supposed to be a kind word may be twisted and misshapen until what was once supposed to offer comfort and happiness now feeds that bit of doubt inside. What was meant to elevate now acts as a weight, dragging you down with such force that it feels like you'll never be able to recover. Don't let these feelings consume you. Let someone in and never let them go. We need to protect each other. Whether or not there is a God somewhere that has our best interest in mind is beyond my knowledge. But I do believe that each and every one of us has a piece of God inside that gives us the strength and the ability to protect. I know it's hard, I really, truly do. But I also know that once you take that first step, it will change you forever, just like it's changed me. Thank you for being my best friend in the world and for supporting me every single day.